Hey guys, you know, you probably noticed at this point, I'm not really hiding it. Sometimes I'm an actor who has a lot of hair, and sometimes I'm just me. And it's a nice tool that I have, but you might have wondered, how does it happen like that? I'm gonna go visit my wig lady right now. You're gonna find out.
This is Renata, the incredible Renata. She's the wig maker of the stars.
Why?
Because I changed.
Remember, you wanted me to get it lighter and lighter.
Right.
And that was wrong, but I followed your lead. Now it's what it needs to be, taken out all the hair down here, put darker in and go with darker hair in.
Darker hair,
yes.
Okay.
Yes, but you didn't let, you know, no, it's too dark, it's too dark.
It's too dark.
I know.
I'm scared of the dark. You are the great wig maker behind Cher's great wigs. You did her wigs for years and years, right?
Mm-hmm. About almost 40 years.
40 years. That's a lot of... How many wigs? Is that dozens and dozens of wigs?
Probably, I don't know.
And are there any other celebrities that do wigs?
Yes, but, you know, I'm very...
You can't. You got to be tight-lipped about
Cher
it.
Cher doesn't give a damn. So is Bette Midler. She doesn't give a damn. You know, a few people don't. Now it has gotten much easier.
Yeah.
Because people have gotten so used to wigs that it doesn't.
They don't hide it.
They don't hide it anymore.
Yeah.
But you never know what.
The men do probably more.
Yeah.
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 We're still very vain.
Yeah, sure.
Men. Yeah.
Men are always more vain than women.
And you're they're always.
I got you.
Yeah, you got me. All right. Well, the whole wig thing is a kind of a funny thing, you know. I started to go bald when I was in my 30s, I guess, and then I had a big comb over for a while. Would I prefer to have a healthy head of hair? I suppose I would, just like I guess I'd prefer to be a little bit taller or something like that. But, you know, the good thing is that for me, I'm a character actor, so being bald sometimes is great. You know, I look at an audition and it says, George, ophthalmologist, you know, 50s, and I go, oh, bald. Or, you know, Nathan, accountant. I can play these roles, and or like on NCIS, which I just played, I decided, you know, this guy's a bald guy. But I have the option, thanks to the wig maker's art. And I didn't really credit that the wig makers were as hot as they are at their art form, and have been for some time, because most of their work is good, and it's hidden. And Renata Leuschner, who I met through Rick Baker, is such a person, and she's done wigs for people, you know, incredible wigs, incredible wig work. I usually wear a wig when I'm doing my impressions, as you might have noticed, because I think it just lends itself more to a better presentation of various characters to not always be a bald guy. It's just an artistic choice, but isn't it nice to have that artistic choice? Now, wigs aren't cheap, they take time to make, they have to be maintained, it becomes a whole thing. But at least you have that option, and I'm a great admirer of the wig maker's craft. Renata, by the way, she studied as a young girl with the Vienna Opera. And wigs and opera go together, you know, just like donuts and coffee, everywhere, not just Vienna. So she learned her craft the hard way, and she is super, super good at it, and that is why Rick Baker always used her at his studio, or used her a lot, and why top film budgets always include a little bit of space there for Renata. And when I go on sets and go in the makeup trailer, and if it's a role where I'm wearing my hair, they usually, the makeup person or the hair person goes, wow, that's a really nice piece. And I say, it's Renata. And they go, ah, they understand. Thanks for watching.